I'm called Dr. Victoria Nachibuka Chidabila. I'm a pediatrician and a neonatologist. I work at Nsambya Hospital. Human milk banking is not new. It has been there a long time. And I think people used to call it wet nursing long ago, before the era of HIV. For example, if maybe a mother dies and then the grandmother would be given children to nurse and the grandmother would feed the babies. But because of infection, we are doing it in a specific, in a modern way to make sure that the milk is safe. And usually these human milk banks have been developed to improve the survival of preterm babies. And these days, a World Health Organization recommends that if a low birth weight baby or preterm, if the mother's milk is not available, the next alternative that can be given to a preterm baby is actually the human milk. So that's why we have the existence of the human milk banks, to improve the survival of preterm babies. Who can donate? So any mother can donate. As long as one, she must have sufficient milk for her baby first, okay? And once she has sufficient milk for her baby first, then she can qualify to donate. But much as she has excess milk, she has to go through a number of series of questions to see that her milk is safe to the other babies. For example, we have to ask her about her lifestyle. Does she take alcohol? How much alcohol does she take? Do they take certain drugs like cocaine or drug? What are their habits basically? And once we are satisfied with their lifestyle, then we also have to take off specific tests for infections like HIV, hepatitis B, and syphilis. And then after that, she can qualify to donate. For now, we are not charging because we are funded. But I think when the funding ends, we have to find a way of maintaining what we have, because every test is paid for. For now, we are helping Nsambya Hospital because transporting pasteurized milk has quite a lot of standards that you must fulfill, especially the transport. So you must transport this milk under a temperature of minus 18. So we shall be scaling up to hospitals like Rubaga, Mengo, Naguru later on, once we get that transport system available. Then that is going to be done very soon. I think one of the challenges is having donors. So many of the donors expect to be paid. But just like when you have blood, you never pay the donors. So sometimes we get donors and they expect to be paid. We can't pay them because it's not sustainable. Then two, most of the donors that we get are mothers that are within. So you find a mother has delivered, she's here for 2 to 3 days, and then she goes. And yet she had a lot of milk. So that means her coming back may not be really a problem. So the main thing we need to rely on is the availability of mothers that are delivering. Like most of the mothers for preterm babies tend to stay long. So when they are donors, we sort of like benefit. The main thing is having the donors, and then they require to be paid. And yet this is basically a voluntary service. Oh no, this milk is so safe. So, well, the process of human milk banking, a human milk bank is a place where, one, you identify donors, two, you screen donors, three, when you have the milk, you pasteurize it. And pasteurization is a process of making milk safe, but without really necessarily destroying the components that are important in the milk. And then four, once we've done the pasteurization, we check for bacteria in the milk. We never give out milk unless we've tested for that bacteria. Actually, once the bacteria is at a certain level, we discard the milk. So this has been tested elsewhere, and actually some studies have also found that even with COVID, even moms that had COVID, if you donate the milk, pasteurization would actually kill the organism. So pasteurization is able to kill most of the viruses and the bacteria that maybe could be contaminating the milk. And the safety is that we never give out milk unless we have done what we call a blood culture, or we have to remove, get a sample of the milk, we take it to the lab, and then they try and grow bacteria on that milk. Then that's when we can give it to babies. My advice to anybody watching and to mothers is that the best gift a mother can ever give to a child is breast milk. The birthday gift for any baby is breast milk. So we encourage mothers to breastfeed because it is safe, and it's the only way that a mother can enable her child grow very well. And it also reduces occurrence of specific diseases that children usually have, like pneumonia, eczema, and ear infections. And it's also very cheap. Thank you.